Nigerian immigration. They will show you the official figure on the website, but they will tell you to process it for this speed. So you have to ask, must we pass that course on everybody coming? I'm excited to secretly so without telling all of you. So whatever you think you spend on your visa, like the Uganda who spent $22, I've spent $58. That's why the visa of Uganda came out under 12 hours. She spent $52 for her visa. I spent $58. I'm sorry I have to tell you this, not to brag, but to tell you that I'm a crazy and excited giver. I want God to choose me. He's still searching. He has not found me. The day God finds me, you will roar.
Amen.
And he will also find you.
Amen.
He has not found me yet. He's still looking for me. So every opportunity for God to find me, I try to plug into it. Because there is a gap. Not that I don't have gap in my life, but his gap is more important than my own gap. I look for a man to come and stand, from among them, to come and stand in the gap. Everybody say, use me.
Use me.
Use me, Lord.
Use me, Lord.
To fulfill your needs.
To fulfill your needs.
I bring my needs to you today. Not for you to fulfill it. But I bring my needs to you.
As a sweet smelling sacrifice.
Before your altar. That I may fulfill your needs. And I know.
If I fulfill your needs.
My needs will die a natural death.
Use me, O Lord.
Make me the woman whom thou seekest.
In Jesus. Amen.
Whom seekest thou, O Lord?
That is Ezekiel chapter.
Number one, I want to tell you the qualities of the people God is seeking.
Verse 30.
Number one, God does not seek the impulsive person.
God does not seek the impulsive.
The people who act before they think. The people who jump to conclusion before thoroughly thinking about a problem. God, if you are impulsive, I'm talking to you. The Holy Ghost is talking to you now. Are you an impulsive person? You draw conclusions suddenly without getting to the end of a matter. And you dismiss it without knowing the will of God, the desire of God, the pleasures of God, the mind of God. I don't like him. That's all. Did God like him? Did God like him? And you say you don't like him. Don't you know you have become an enemy of God? I don't like him. I just don't want to see him. You are looking for God's trouble. You are looking for God's trouble. Whom seekest thou, O God? One, God does not seek for the impossible person. Number two, God does not seek for a slave. A slave is too hampered, too chained down by his chains of slavery. A slave cannot be used by God. I'm coming to tell you what I mean by that. Because you want to see me, what have you said? You don't know what I mean by slave. I'm not talking about this slave. Joseph did not hold anybody. Potiphar was eternally grateful to Joseph. He was so grateful because anything Joseph touched in the house of Potiphar blossomed. So why is Potiphar sharing property with him? Hand over everything. So that if you hand over everything and he touches everything, everything will blossom. Joseph was not indebted to Potiphar. I'm telling you the meaning of slavery. How can you say, I'm a free man, and you are holy, and the borrower is a slave to the owner? I'm telling you, because when we get to the subject of slavery, dangerous prayers will be prayed. But don't pray without understanding. Don't pray without understanding. God will not use an impulsive person. God will not use a slave. Come and fight me if you dare. How can this man say, I'm a slave because I borrow money? Everybody does it. God said, hold no man. Romans 13, hold no man. Because he knows once you hold a man, he can use you. Whom seekest thou, O Lord? Whom seekest thou?